It's been referred to as the Oasis, the Metaverse, and the Matrix. You may have heard people talking about virtual reality, or VR for short, as the hottest new tech innovation since the internet. I mean, now we can actually walk in someone else's shoes. Maybe you're in a war-torn village somewhere, or swimming through an ocean reef, or maybe you just want to be really scared watching a horror movie. VR really hit it big in 2014. That's when Facebook acquired Oculus, the company that created the Oculus Rift. Since then, 360 video has pretty much exploded. VR fans say that it creates an in-real-life sense of being there. And this sense of reality is why some have dubbed it the empathy machine. Empathy is that feeling when you understand and share someone else's experiences almost as if they're your own. But can VR really make us more empathetic? Research shows that even regular old movies can change our brain chemistry, making us care more about others. For example, simple stories can cause the brain to produce the stress hormone, cortisol, and the love hormone, oxytocin. And this can make us want to donate money to a cause or help others, a technique advertisers know all too well. Ads often hook you in with those compelling stories, and just when you're emotionally invested, bam, they convince you to buy their product or fork over your money. Stanford's virtual reality lab is studying how VR affects empathy. To get an inside look at this, we took a trip to the lab and met up with Tobin Asher.
What we study here are the psychological and behavioral effects of virtual reality. We want to know how VR affects individuals not only when they're in a headset, in the virtual environment, but also once they've left the virtual world, re-entered the real world. How do these effects stay with them? So you're going to become a superhero. Now, we would tell participants that there had been an emergency. The city had been evacuated, but there was a child left behind. And your job would be to fly around, find the child, and save the child's life. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, you're going to put your hands above your head to take off. So we had participants in two different conditions. We had the superhero condition, that's what you're currently in, flying around, trying to save the child's life. And then the other group of participants were in a condition in which they were flying around the city as if they were in a helicopter. After the experiment was supposedly over, so the participants were outside of VR at this point, the experimenter faked an accident, they fumbled with the equipment, knocked some items off a table, and we measured the reaction times of the participants. What we found was that the participants in the superhero condition were much faster to help and more thorough in their helpfulness than those in the helicopter condition. So both in VR, but we find that one group of participants ends up being more helpful. And so this is really speaking to the importance of the experience that you have in virtual reality and how this can shape your behavior later on. This is one study of many, and there's always more research to be done. And I will never claim that virtual reality is the thing that absolutely makes people empathetic or is a magical tool that will make people empathetic or works every time. But we do find in very specific instances when used well that we can see differences in the way that virtual reality affects people than other mediums.
So research shows VR does uniquely provoke empathy. But will VR really deliver on all these promises? These high school students from Baltimore are using VR to tell their stories. They've been working with Digital Promise, a nonprofit that has a mission to connect high school students with VR technology.
I can do this.
You'll never have any friends here.
I'm gonna find you later.
Our story, Breaking Barriers, is about how anxiety can alter your perception of reality. Our protagonist is new to a school and figures are coming up to her saying negative comments, but essentially you realize that it is just her imagination. It's all in her head.
I suffer from anxiety in a lot of social circumstances. I brought a lot of ideas from how I feel to actually make it feel more realistic.
Why are you here?
When the people just kept walking up to me, like I never spoke to them. I didn't even sit at the same table as them. And they just walked up to me, said something. But it made me mad, especially when the girl threatened me. Like, it kind of got like an adrenaline rush. Like, I wanted to say something, but I couldn't.
For years, we've been hearing about the virtual explosion, but it hasn't really taken off yet. The cost of running VR equipment are way too high for the average person. While companies like Facebook, Google, and Microsoft continue to invest heavily in VR projects, VR so far isn't making nearly as much money as they hoped. There's also some health concerns, things you'd expect from wearing a headset like motion sickness, headaches, but there are also other less common health concerns like cyber sickness and post-VR sadness. Yeah, look those up. And of course, this needs more research. We're not trying to scare you or anything. But now it's your turn. What story would you tell if you could immerse someone in your world? I'd personally like to garden a lot, so my VR world would be like a garden, and then like you would just be setting up, like, you know, watering the plants and seeds in the ground, and like, because I feel like that's another form of meditation and like tranquility, and that's what I would use VR for personally. But I don't know what you guys have in mind. Let us know in the comments below. And if you like this video, you should like, subscribe, and watch all the other ones. And tell your friends to do the same thing.